discussing EFSI today, 1 year later, where we are, what we have achieved so far. I'm, as you know maybe, member of ENCO Committee in the European Parliament, and I'm also a former State Secretary at the Ministry of Labour, Family and Social Affairs in our country, which is Slovenia. Social part of our society is ranking so far and still will really high on my scale of values. And I'm always reminding my colleagues from the other areas, as you know, maybe I'm also a member of EU Committee, where social matters are not so high on the agenda. And I'm remembering my colleagues all the time that we cannot afford to ignore this part of life nor policies. In my opinion of the EFSI implementation for the ENCO Committee, I stressed out the need that the main aim of EFSI should be to create growth and a dynamic labor market in the EU, as well as to enhance the well-being of the EU citizens. We need to invest in high-quality social and health services. Commission and European Investment Bank should increase investment in projects which will support 80 million people, almost 20% of the population of the European people with disabilities. However, we are now in a some kind strange situation. We are waiting for what the Commission will say next week. The State of the Union speech and also the EFSI 2.0 proposal is foreseen right now. And I'm looking forward to hear from our president that we need to include social services in EFSI. We need to hear from him, from Jean-Claude Juncker, that it is time to stop ignoring social agenda. I really hope to hear a few words on this topic here as well in the panel and at this seminar. Well, this is the only way that we can show our citizens that we care, that we really don't ignore their needs, and that they are important as human beings and as a part of our society. I would like to say in advance that I'm looking forward to the outcome of this seminar. I will also spread all your words wherever and whenever possible. Well, this is my mission, and this is what I can do as a member of the European Parliament. And now let me conclude with my words, and I'm giving the floor to Mr. Luke Zardello, Secretary General.